From the John DeVita Broadcast Center, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another broadcast of Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John DeVita Broadcast Center on the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network and Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich on Thursday, June the 23rd, the year 2016. And now, here he is, Mr. Fred Belcastro.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
Smiles with you.
And when you're laughing,
when you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing.
When the sun comes shining through,
shining through.
When you're crying,
when you're crying,
you bring on the rain,
bring on the
stop
rain.
Your sighing,
stop your
sighing. Won't you be happy again?
Happy again.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling.
Keep on smiling.
Good morning and welcome to the Wealth and Wisdom program. My name is Fred Belcastro, your host, and during the next 30 minutes, we're going to talk about using our wisdom to grow and protect our wealth. And as usual, we're broadcasting this morning from the John DeVita Broadcast Center here on the northwest side of Chicago, and you're listening to us on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS. And need I remind you that during the months of June and July, we can be heard on Thursday morning, 10:30 a.m., and after July, after in the beginning of August, you'll be listening to us at our regular scheduled time, Friday mornings, each Friday morning at 10:30. But during the next 2 months, June and July, you're listening on Thursday morning, Jack FM 89.7. I don't do a lot of TV watching. My wife watches programs, and as we were raising children, we've put on various shows. One of the shows that the kids always enjoyed, I think at Halloween time and at Christmas time, was Charlie Brown. I think that's the Peanuts character from the comic strips. Nevertheless, my wife tells me that Charlie Brown even had a teacher, and the teacher would comment by saying, "Wow, wow, 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 wow." And then Seinfeld show, they had Elaine going blah, 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 blah. The reason I go, "Wow, wow, 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 wow," is that this is a radio show, and we're talking about wealth and wisdom. And there's so much wealth and wisdom over the airwaves today. Man, I don't know what to tune in and what to tune out. I listen to it all, and a lot of it is wow, 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 wow. All right, let me tell you what I mean, what I'm getting to. Talking about conventional wisdom and how to build our wealth using our intelligence, and we're taught to focus on three main areas. Number one, what we've got to do, we've got to earn a higher rate of interest, got a higher rate of return. Do I mention the increased risk that goes along with the higher rate? Well, nevertheless, let's try to earn more money, find better investments and higher returns. Another area, you've got to save money. You've got to save your money. Get out of debt, folks. Save the money. Where are you going to get the money to save? We're not going to dig it up out of the backyards, or we're not going to pull it off a tree like a piece of fruit. We're going to have to reduce your current lifestyle. So in other words, another kids going to these fine suburban schools, let's send them to maybe what we might consider an undesirable school. Well, what do they need the education for? We've got a TV. Well, don't they have Google on their phones? Reduce our standard of living. That's what's told to us. That's how we build our wealth, by saving more. And when we save more, we take it from our current lifestyle. All right, how about maximize our contributions to qualified plans? I've heard a CPA. CPA does a ton of tax work. I'm sure he passed the examinations. And he said he would give the advice that you should put as much as you can into your qualified plans. That's the conventional wisdom. And I say to that, wow, 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 wow. Listen, according to the financial service giant, ING, if conventional wisdom is working, if it's so that we should do all these things that the so-called gurus or these advisors tell us to do, how come 90% of the people that are retired are not on target to retire at their pre-retirement income levels. How come over 90% of the people have to take a reduction in standard of living when they retire or are forced to quit work? Why are so many people delaying their retirement? How many people are working past 60, 65? Remember the people that used to retire at 55, 58, 60? How come people now are retiring at 70 and 75? They're delaying their retirement. Why are so many people that are retired unretiring? Let's retire. Can't retire. Let's go back to work. Why? The conventional wisdom. Wow, 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 wow. You can get 12% in mutual funds. Invest as much as you can in your qualified plans. Why do seniors then have to cut back on basic services? I see people standing in line at the pharmaceutical pharmacy getting medications and counting pennies and putting it on credit cards. All this conventional wisdom, all these this expert advice is just so much blah, 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 blah. I think this has created, listen to these people, have created a notion or an understanding that all we have to do to be financially successful would be to buy the right products. Listen, have you heard the individuals on TV and in the books tell us you can get 12% in a mutual fund? Well, what I did is I got some real rate of return, a yardstick, and this is from 72 to 96, large company stocks. And you're right. You will average 12%. You can, in fact, the figure comes out to 12.6 rate of return. And year by year, in 72, these large company stocks, mutual funds, averaged 19%. So if you put your money in at the beginning of the year and took it out at the end of the year, if you were a one-year investor, you would earn 19%. 74, a one-year investor, lost 26. Let's not forget that. Let's go to 1975, and the investor, according to the charts, would have earned 37%. These are the pie in the sky. These are the figures that were given. And you can do this, you can do that. There's one return here of 27%, 28%. Isn't that great? 30%. These are great rates of return, and that certainly would equate if we averaged it out to 12.6%. Wow, 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 here we go again. Was there any inflation during this period of time? Did we pay taxes on this 37%, 23%, 18%, 6%, 18%, 5%? Do we pay taxes? Do you live in the United States? Are you a citizen? You pay your taxes. You have a Social Security number? You file by April 15th each and every year? Okay, you pay a tax. So now when we get the 12.6 return, we have to pay a tax, don't we? And in the average tax bracket, figuring federal and state, 25%, that'll mean that we'll pay a little more than 3% in taxes from that gain. Subtracting that, we come up with a 9.4. Now, they've averaged. We haven't earned 12%, because there's a difference between actual receiving it and the averages. We've gone through, we spent show after program after show after that. But we wind up, after paying our taxes on our 12% that we're told to do by the individuals who know more than we do, we must listen to them. 9.4, that ain't bad. We're still walking away with close to 9%. How about inflation? All the seniors that are receiving Social Security know that there hasn't been any inflation because they haven't had a raise in their checks. But nevertheless, let's not be stupid about this. We're supposed to be a little bit smarter than the average bear. So our 9.4 would be reduced by the amount of inflation. If I'm going to give you off the charts 12.6 rate of return, you also have to accept the 5.6 average rate of inflation as well through those years. And when we do that, when we subtract the numbers, it's a 3.8 rate of return. Blah, 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 wah, 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 wah. 3.8, not 12 that you're going to wind up in your pocket. But listen, how much smarter am I to be able to say, here's how you can get 12.5% by investing in a good mutual fund? Well, Mr. Advisor, Mr. Genius, show me the the 12.5% that I'm going to be receiving. And don't just make me, as I keep talking about an unverifiable promise, that this is the rate of return. This is what I'm actually going to receive. The reason I talk about this is that many of us have approached the golden years, and going along with my golden years spending game, I've got to admit, listen, if you're beyond 60 years old, so am I. If you're beyond 65 and receiving Social Security, yeah, me too. And I've been doing this for over 50 years. I've enjoyed talking both on the radio and talking over dining room tables, desks, and kitchen tables. But let me mention something that I heard from an individual who is an icon in the insurance business by the name of Joe Grandolfo. Joe Grandolfo said during one of his seminars I'd been to, he said, there's over 746,000 licensed financial representatives in this country alone. And so I think it's important, and it's critical, that you know a little bit about their background, a little bit about their qualifications before just blindly accepting their advice. Doesn't make them a guru, doesn't make them all-knowing, because they publish a few books or are on radio just the same as mine. But listen, my background, you know, I was a sales manager at Metropolitan Life. Remember that company? Used to be the largest life insurance company in the world. Metropolitan Life, in fact, I'm sure I'm talking to many of their policyholders right now. I've passed a certified financial planner licensing and examination. So so back in the middle of 85, I became a certified financial planner. Then always looking to improve and gain education, I became a stockbroker with Merrill Lynch. Now, as a stockbroker at Merrill Lynch, did I pass a simple examination, a Series 6, that allows me to sell mutual funds and variable annuities? No. You have to take a 7 and a 63. A Series 7 allows you then to sell individual stocks. If you're taking advice from an individual that only has a Series 6, something's lacking, because the Series 7 is next. That's what should be taken. And in addition to that, though, I also took and passed a 24 examination that allowed me to have an office of supervisory jurisdiction in Oak Park, where I hired and fired and ran a staff of stockbrokers. I was also a registered principal with the National Security. Yeah, I talk about it. I don't mean to go wah, 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 wah. But when you say something, you should be able to back it up. You should have the experience and the knowledge. License and life, health, accident, home, auto. Yeah, over and over. And the only reason I bring you this is that saying over and over. Listen, I think the way I function, my work is unique in a couple of ways. I don't just sit here and give you unverifiable promises of better investments, higher returns. And all I have to back that up is saying, trust me, you'll get 12%. Trust me, this does 15%. It may have done it last year, the year before, the year before, the year before, but we don't drive down the street looking in the rearview mirror. What's going to happen with my money when I give it to you? What am I going to get? Well, that's an unverifiable promise to say that you're going to get this or get that. Well, just saying, trust me. Hey, wah, wah, wah. Trust me. What I will do, though, I'll help you create a financial plan that'll guarantee what you want to happen for you and the people you love will happen, and it'll give you these results, I think, compared to your current plan. We don't use any additional risk, no reduction in lifestyle. You don't take money out of your standard of living in order to do any programming or planning. Guaranteeing more money over your lifetime compared to your present plan, better asset protection. And I've always said, liquidity, use, and control. If you can't have the use and control of your money, it's somebody else's. Let's not be fooled. If you don't have your money, someone else does. Another thing, the second thing I do that I believe is somewhat unique, is that the subject of trust. That trust, listen, is earned over time. I've been in the business 50 years. I could bring you to Franklin Park and show you one of my first customers. For that reason, I don't ask people to just take my word. Nor will I ever ask you to do something that I can't prove or mathematically verify that it's the right thing to do. But let's listen to this young man sing this song and see what we think about it.
Angel, angel, whoa, 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 angel, angel. From up above, the Lord smiled down on me and sent an angel to love. You are my special angel, right from paradise. I know you're an angel, heaven is in your eyes. The smile from your lips bring the summer sunshine. Tears from your eyes bring the rain. I feel your touch, your warmth, embrace, and I'm in heaven again. You are my special angel through eternity. I'll have my special angel
talked about that individual singing that song. That was out of 1957, the voice of Bobby Helms. Maybe you have heard that song before, maybe you haven't. It was popularized, I think, in the 60s by the Vogues, but the original was Bobby Helms, and it was a country and western twang to it. I talked about the 12% along with those charts and many individuals I've received phone calls. And once again, our phone where we can be reached during the week is area 630-673-4360. Or if you prefer, and I find it convenient, the email. My email address is fbellsecure, F-B-E-L-S-E-C-U-R-E at AOL.com. But nevertheless, I wanted to bring up the chart of CDs and Treasury bills in the period of time from 72 to 96. And I know this could be boring. Again, the concept, put it in your mind. There are taxes and inflation. And inflation subtracted from the rate of return that you have is what's considered a real rate of return. But you don't pay taxes on the real rate. You pay the taxes on the gross. So if the gross is 7%, and that's what it's averaged. The Treasury bills have averaged 7%. In a 25% tax bracket, you've paid 1.75% on that. Subtracting that gives you a 5.2 net after taxes. Subtracting the 5.2 from the after inflation rate of 5.6, you come up with 40 basis points, which is a little less than a half of 1% in your pocket. So when we think or see these wonderful returns, these say you can get 7, 8, 10%, well, that's just so much blah, blah, blah. I have no idea why we're filled with it, why we believe it. We've got to realize that we pay taxes on all of these gains, whether we pay them today or we pay them tomorrow. Pay me now or pay me later. Remember that commercial? What would you rather do? You'd rather pay the guy now, wouldn't you? All right. Where's conventional wisdom that puts us in the hole? Let me mention an analogy, and I've used this before. I'm not a golfer. I played when I was younger. It took up a lot of my time, and I found myself on the golf course hitting a ball and then walking in the grass thinking about what should be done at the office. So I said, why don't I just skip this whole thing here and go to the office? And that's what I did. But nevertheless, using the golf as a picture of the dilemma that we have, moving from one financial product, listening to one financial advisor to another, and just searching the highest return that we can get is like buying new clubs. I remember when Big Bertha came out, a fellow in our office had to get the new Big Bertha because it would improve his game, improve that drive. We understand and we recognize and realize, admit, it's important to have good clubs. But the greatest impact on the game of golf will come from practicing your swing, from the swing. And I've related it to saying that the process, what we do with our money, how we put our money away, how we adapt to conventional wisdom or lack of conventional wisdom in the planning process is the most important, not the products. So if we're looking from this guy to that guy to find the best, there are, you need a product to be in the game. You need a golf club to be in the game. But if we put all the emphasis on just finding the game, we might lose. But let me leave it up to you. We're going to play in the Masters, all right? And you've got a ticket to play in the Masters. You've got two options available to you. Number one, you could have the clubs of any player who's ever played the round of golf. Anybody, Ben Hogan, the Tiger Wood, Jack Nicholson, whatever. You can have their clubs, best clubs in the world. Or you can have their ability. Which one would you choose? Which one? You can't have both. Take one of them, their clubs or their ability. You see? You'd have to take their ability, the swing. And then the financial institutions, the companies on the corner, these storefronts will offer you products. We'll refer to as the clubs. Now, you need the clubs to play the game, but having the right swing, the right ability is a far greater value. Having the correct swing financially means that you have avoided, again, the unnecessary wealth transfers. Remember when I said there's more to be gained from my clients in helping them find the money that they're currently losing unknowingly and unnecessarily. We bring that money back to the table, put it in one of two places or both places, help it increase your lifestyle. But listen, the money you're spending on debt service, we could give you and your family a nice vacation every year. Bad clubs and a great swing will beat great clubs and a bad swing every single time. So when we focus on just increasing our money by getting higher investment returns with promises of unverifiable promises that this is going to give you 12-15, this is going to the best thing since sliced bread, all these things that you say, if we just look for that, it's like trying to fill a leaky bucket by just pouring in more investments, more money, more water. And it leaks out. Would you do that? Would you pour money and money and money into a bucket or a pot that has a hole in it? And that's what we're doing if we're giving away all of our money through debt services. Remember when I first came on the air here at WRHS, I was talking about the ton traps that we should avoid. Remember I told you about taxes, inflation, the opportunity costs, interest rates, and interest rate expenses. would devastate an individual's portfolio. But let's plug those leaks in our bucket. Let's close up that interest expenses unnecessarily and unneeded interest expenses. Avoid these necessary transfers. That's where you begin. You don't begin by looking for a product and hoping to be able to hit a home run with it. But let me take another sip of coffee and listen to where you are.
Where are you, little star?
That was 1958, The Elegants singing Where Are You, Little Star. All right, I could ask you to think and listen. Ask these questions to your present advisor. And I've said in the past from Mr. Mariani, one of my 8th grade math teachers, you could lead a horse to water, but you can't make him think. Think, think, think. If you don't want to think about it, ask your advisor. If you were at your current level, doing the same things you did yesterday, you do it tomorrow, how long will you have to continue working to be able to retire at your present lifestyle? What rate of return do you need to earn to be able to live at your present lifestyle in retirement? What rate of return do you, what rate of return are you receiving on your present investments? All over. I don't care about, I've got this 401, this IRA, honey, we're getting this on the CD. What are you getting on all of it? Because all of it is you, isn't it? All of it is you and your family. How much can you spend when you retire and have the money last your entire life expectancy? Do you know the answer to that question? What other options do you have? Have you done any planning? Have you called me about the golden year spending game planning option that I have? How can you improve on what you're doing? Think, because this is your dollars. When we talk about this is the Wealth and Wisdom program, all I'm doing is trying to make you think, trying to make you understand that when we receive information, sometimes we don't get the whole story. You need to realize that taxes and inflation, opportunity costs that we lose, interest rates, the interest expenses that we have from from our credit cards and from our revolving charge cards, from making large purchases on major appliances and automobiles, the financial costs that are involved in all of these programs that we seem to buy into. Lead a horse to water, but you can't make them think. Let's chew on that for a while. And in the meantime, in the days to come, let's be kind to one another, try to help one another, and I enjoyed the talking to you this morning. Look forward to talking to you once again next week. Thanks for listening. Thanks for your support of the 89.7 WRHS Jack FM station here in Norridge. And in the meantime, until next week, make somebody smile.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
Smiles with you.
And when you're laughing,
when you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing.
Mm, when the sun comes shining through.
Shining through.
When you're crying,
when you're crying,
you bring on the rain.
Bring on the
stop
rain.
Your sighing.
Stop your
won't you be happy again?
Happy again.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling.
Keep on smiling,
keep on smiling,
and the world will smile.
You have been listening to Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John DeVita Broadcast Center on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich and the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network on Thursday, June the 23rd, the year 2016. This broadcast was directed by John DeVita. Our special thanks to radio station manager Kevin Zeflik of WRHS-FM Norwich and the executive producer of the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network, Mr. John Chikanda. Until next time, friends, please be safe and thanks for listening. This broadcast was pre-recorded on Wednesday, June the 22nd, the year 2016. Have a great day, everyone. And this is Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM. Norridge, Illinois. Have a safe and enjoyable weekend, friends. See you next week.